So does anyone remember about a year ago, I made a video response to the topic at hand when PETA, PETA, the organization against people eating meat and against any type of animal abuse. I made a video about them when they attacked one of my favorite video games. And that video game was Battlefield 3. They attacked this game by saying that it supports animal abuse because in the game, there's a specific scene when you're laying on the ground and there's guards out there looking for you, and a rat, a big fat rat, comes up to you and bites your hand. It attacks you. And you pull out a knife and you stab it. PETA jumped on this and said, "Look at this! This game is supporting animal abuse!" When in reality, the rat was actually attacking the person, and you only did it in self-defense. I think if any animal is actually trying to hurt you or attack you have the right to pretty much kill it. I have no qualms about that. But that's besides the point. PETA attacked Battlefield 3 for animal abuse of killing a rat. Second thing PETA also did was they attacked Mario. Mario wore that little, what is it, raccoon? There's a certain gaming terminology for what he wore. But they attacked and said that supports animal abuse because Mario must have skinned a raccoon! And well, PETA falls to a whole new level, and they have now attacked something that I hold dearly to, Pokemon. So, for those of you who are not in the gaming realm of things, Pokemon Black and White 2, I think, came out yesterday, no. Was released relatively in the past few days. The game was released, and PETA jumps on it by releasing a parody of a Pokemon looking like this. So as you can see in this photo, you have Pokemon with blood all over them, with chains, and the Pokemon masters look like a psychotic madman serial killer who wants to, I don't even know how to describe it, hurt people. And yes, as usual, PETA is claiming that Pokemon supports animal cruelty and abuse. When I first saw the photo that I just showed you, I actually thought it was a joke parody of PETA. I actually thought someone was making fun of PETA until I realized that it wasn't. It was PETA making fun of Pokemon by saying that it supports animal abuse and whatever. And I guess really what my only response to this is that, let me put it this way. I grew up playing Pokemon. Pokemon actually taught me that I should care for my animals. When I was playing Pokemon on the original green Game Boy, I remember it, I was infatuated with the idea of wanting to take care of my Pokemon. Anytime it would get hurt, it would get poisoned, it would get sick, I would get on my little bicycle and go. However the theme song goes, I know that was way off, but I would ride my bike to the hospital as fast as I possibly could to take care of my Pokemon. I'd give them potions, I'd do everything in my power to build my Pokemon to be a big, strong Pokemon, and I looked at the Pokemon as like this little virtual creature because my parents didn't at the time didn't want animals in the house when I was really, really young, and I didn't get a dog until I think I was 7 years or 8 years old to begin with, and I grew up playing Pokemon. And of course, PETA doesn't really offer any valid reason as to how it supports animal abuse, because number one, Pokemon are not even animals. They're like creatures. They're not real. I mean, what's it going to be next, PETA? Are you going to attack The Hobbit or The Lord of the Rings because there are orcs in it? I know orcs are a fictional creature, but I guess they could slightly resemble humans. So you should be attacking Lord of the Rings too because people kill orcs. How far are you going to go? This is what it actually boils down to. I think PETA is such of a scum organization that the only reason they get any publicity at all is by attacking these little small trivial things that don't even correlate or match to what their cause is. Oh, we're against animal abuse, so let's attack everything and everyone who uses animals, whether it's glorifying animals, whether it's helping animals, it's animal abuse. And you know what's really crazy? I've seen more love and more respect to creatures that don't even exist in Pokemon games than I see that with people who actually have animals and actually abuse them. And let's be realistic here. How many small kids are going to play Pokemon? Much less, is there any statistics to support this? And the answer is no. How many little kids are going to play Pokemon and then after they're done playing the game say, I want to go out and get my own animal and abuse him and not feed him and hit him and beat him to death with a baseball bat? Pokemon's teaching me animal abuse. How many people have actually, well, I'm sure there's some weird, odd, strange person who somehow twists things into their own ideology into doing whatever, justifying what they want to do. But my point is, if you're a human and you've played Pokemon, I guarantee you that kids are not formulating an idea of animal abuse by playing Pokemon. I mean, in PETA's photo, they have Pikachu with blood all over him. Where in Pokemon is there any blood? And this is the problem. They also exaggerate every other story. And then the good thing is they attack all these little innocent things like Pokemon, but then they release like this. I mean, come on. You promote something like this, but then you say something like Pokemon is this damaging thing to society and children. My question is, why hasn't PETA went after the company that made Angry Birds? Because after all, you're pulling a bird, and you're pulling them back, slingshotting them into a building. That's violence. Why hasn't PETA went after Angry Birds? But instead, they go after something that's been around for, what, 14 years or 15 years? To sum this video up in short, right here is a bacon roast beef grilled cheese sandwich. And my message to you, PETA, if any PETA member is watching this video, is you can suck my bacon. Quench your heartbeat. Quench your heartbeat. Quench your heartbeat, baby. Quench your heartbeat.